Get ready to match the stars. Bill Daly, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reich, Lee Merriweather, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flay. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rayburn.
Johnny Olson and friends. A warm welcome to all of our regulars. What the heck is that, Fanny?
It's an owl.
It's an owl?
Yeah, owl.
It's beautiful. It's breathing. Yes. I don't believe this. Is this the real Connie Van Dyke?
It just does something to me.
Yes.
No, my hairdresser on Barnaby Jones, Barbara Lamson, gave me a whole bunch of wigs for Christmas, and I just started wearing them. I love them.
Yeah.
Is that a wig?
Is that a wig?
Doesn't look
where
like
does it,
it
end, and where does it begin?
I
well, let's
tell.
Not get it. How are you, Bill? Good. Now, let's say hello to our two players here, Wendy Wilchinski and Gary Armstrong. Wendy? Wendy's our current champ. She has a total of $2,850 to her credit. And she's going to be challenged now by Gary Armstrong, who will tell us the story of his life.
Yes, it's very quick. I work for a
sporting... Time's up. That's all. Short life, wasn't it? Short life, Gary Armstrong.
Work for a sporting goods distributor.
Yeah.
And I enjoy sports, basically.
That's it, huh? Where do you live?
Laguna Beach.
Laguna Beach. And where do you... are you married?
No.
No. Are you old enough to be married?
Depends.
Depends on what?
I don't want it yet.
You don't want it yet?
No.
All right, let us know when you want it.
Okay.
Okay. We'll start this game in a moment or so, but right now, we have this message for you. Hello there. We are ready to have a go at it. If you're ready to have a go at it, we'll ask our challenger to make his selection.
A.
A. Everybody plays. Charles Nelson Reilly said...
But what did Charles Nelson Reilly say?
He said, I was once in a Broadway show that was so bad. I'm glad you asked. The audience didn't throw tomatoes, they threw blank. I didn't rehearse that imitation of you, Charles. Are you ashamed of me?
No, but it should be lower.
Should be lower? Yes. I was once in a Broadway show that was so bad, the audience didn't throw tomatoes, they threw blank. That's how bad that Broadway show was.
Hi, hon.
Okay. All right, the lower tier is just about ready here. Charles was not last for a change because he was there. Gary Armstrong. Charles Nelson Reilly said, I was once in a Broadway show that was so bad, the audience didn't throw tomatoes, they threw...
Bullets.
Bullets. Well, you got the idea, didn't you?
Very hard to do.
Gotta give him A for effort.
Well, I saw the show and I threw up.
So there you go.
Yeah, why not tell you?
All right, Bill. Finally made the team. Now, Brett.
Every once in a while, he gets his little act together.
Yeah, that's
he?
Every once in a while there.
I said they threw the fruits.
They threw the fruits.
You can
tomatoes and apples
want.
And pears and all of that sort of thing, though. Hello, Charles. You were there.
I said eggs. I'm sorry, Gary.
You said eggs. Gary's looking for the answer. I was once in a Broadway show. The audio that was so bad the audience didn't throw tomatoes, they threw bullets. What do you say, Lee?
I said, well, radishes.
Radishes? How would you explain that?
Hot air and
oh.
I don't know.
Oh, I see. Oh. All right, Richard.
I thought it was for a repeat performance. A little hamburger. They threw up.
They threw up. All right, Miss Fanny, honey.
I was trying to think of the biggest fruit there was. So I wrote watermelon.
Watermelon. Charles, you didn't tell us the truth, did you?
No.
Now, let's see. Wendy, are you ready for yours?
Yeah.
Jimmy said, the head waiter at that restaurant doesn't like me. He sat us at the worst table in the place. It was in the blank. The head waiter at that restaurant doesn't like me. He sat us in the worst table in the place. It was in the blank.
Okay.
All right. Put something on your little card. Get your little mind going. And away we go. Wendy, Jimmy said the head waiter at that restaurant didn't like me. He sat us at the worst table in the place. It was in the...
It was in the kitchen?
In the kitchen. I don't know her. She's the champ. Leave her alone. Bill, where was this table?
Oh, I've been there. I have to go there right now, to the John.
John. So that's the kind of material you like. That's the kind of bunch you are, is it? Okay. Brett?
I didn't want to discriminate between male and female, so I said the John John.
The John John. That's two of those, Wendy. And Charles?
I'm going to be very calm and just continue. Kitchen.
Kitchen. One for Wendy. Lee, Wendy is looking for the answer. Sat us in the worst table in the place. It was in the kitchen, is what she says. What do you say?
Well, unlike Brett, I do discriminate. Ladies' room.
Ladies' room. King Richard.
I went to the restaurant with Dick Wesson.
You did?
Marvelous actor.
Yes, an excellent actor.
But neither of us, you know, were that big a name, so they... sat us in the kitchen.
In the kitchen. Super Wendy. Yes, and a good comedian, too. Oh, yes, right. And Miss Fanny, honey.
In the furnace.
So, Wendy, you chalked up two there, and that's the way the score stands at the end of round one. 2-0 favor the champ. Round two coming up, but first this. Now, we go to round two. Score is 2-0 favor the champ. Challenger, would you make your selection, please?
I'll stick with A.
Stick with A, because it was so good to you last time, Gary? Now, listen, Gary. At the circus, the fat lady said, she says, I hate those Siamese twins. Yesterday, those guys couldn't find their hats, so they wore my blank on their heads.
The fat lady said that.
She said, I hate those Siamese twins. Yesterday, those guys couldn't find their hat, so they wore my blank on their heads.
I think it's a fairly obvious answer.
Okay, Charles is ready. He's writing, so I will slowly walk over here to Gary Armstrong. Call on Gary Armstrong. At the circus, the fat lady said, I hate those Siamese twins. Yesterday, those guys couldn't find their hats, so they wore my blank on their heads.
Bra.
Bra!
A very, very fat lady, right?
Yes, very fat.
I think this is acceptable. Pasties, is that good?
No.
Pasties are not, well, they cover up things, right?
No, yeah, but it's not a bra. Pasty is not a bra. Pasty is a...
Well, I'm going to take these out of here.
Yeah, get them out of there, yeah.
All right.
What did you say, my dear?
I love the image of someone who looks like Shelley Winters in pasties, don't you? I said bra.
Bra, there's one. You're right. This fugitive from the Bob Newhart show, you know, he has his ups and downs, gives a brilliant, funny answer, and then he comes up with pasties. Holy mackerel. Yes, Charles?
You know, I don't know in this country what you... It's a bra, that's what they wear, but in my country you call it, when I decide on what accent this is, the brassiere.
Brassiere. Brassiere. Le brassiere. Couldn't find their hats, so they wore my bra on their heads, according to Gary. What do you say, madam?
And Charlie and I are from the same country, brassiere.
Brassiere.
That's
good for you. You got a couple for him?
No, but I have a cousin in Philadelphia we're very worried about. Now, the English translation is Bray.
Bray, yes. So there it is. That's four. That's eight altogether for him. How about you?
Well, you know, I share a dressing room with Brett, and it just makes me laugh to see a training bra again. But I wrote bra.
Now, Wendy, he's got five and you've got two. That means three to tie, four to win. Listen carefully. Everybody plays except Richard and Charles. From his hospital bed, Tom said, "Today I got two cards. My mother sent me a get well card. My mother-in-law sent me a get blank card."
Wait a minute.
Did you hear all that? From his hospital bed, Tom said, "Today I got two cards. My mother sent me a get well card. My mother-in-law sent me a get blank card. Get well card and a get blank card." You play. He does not play. Not in her first round.
Oh.
Not in her first round. It was Richard.
I think we're going to have another losing answer up here.
Charles here. You've got yours, you've got yours. Bill, we're waiting for you.
Just okay.
It's back to the Bob Newhart Show
okay,
if you don't do it.
Okay, back here again.
All right. No, all right. Now, Wendy, from his hospital bed, Tom said, "Today I got two cards. My mother sent me a get well card. My mother-in-law sent me a get blank card."
There's no such thing but a get lost card.
A get lost card. Bill, the audience likes her choice.
Boy, I loved it. I wish I could have thought of that. That's really a neat one. Boy, I really got just confused. I said a get-out card.
I'm get out?
I don't even know what that means.
Now, really. Wait a minute. Get out and get lost? Isn't that
get
the same?
Get out. Get lost.
No.
No. We get a no-no?
No, I'm just giving the judge a second
thank
chance because sometimes he makes a hasty decision.
Okay. Well.
And sometimes he doesn't listen. Yes. Got a match exactly. What do you say, Brett? Got to match everybody else to stay in the game
I
here. It's up to you.
I cannot tell you how concerned I am about myself. I don't mean to discuss my own personal problems, but I said get out.
You did. All right. So that means Gary wins the game. What the rest of you have? Congratulate you. Stand right there for a second or so, and we'll say goodbye to Wendy Wilczynski, who is leaving here with a total of
$2,850.
That's great. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, my dear. Now, as she's spinning off, we'll spin this message for him, and we'll hurry back and see how he does. Please, sir, here, and we'll have a go at it. Are you ready for this?
Yes.
Now, you watch this show quite often?
Yes.
You know how it goes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, tell me how it goes.
Carefully.
All right, we'll very carefully say this. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. George Blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, Gary, but you've got to match it. Now, if you match that answer they gave second most frequently, you get $250. The third one gets you $100. Hey, listen, could we turn that fan on low speed? It's blowing harder than it's ever blown. Look at the way his hair is blowing. Gonna muss my hair, too. Can we do that? Thank you very much. Now, three of our celebrities are permitted to help. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Very close friend of mine, George Washington.
George Washington is one.
Lee?
Lee, have you got one?
A toss-up. I'll try George Burns.
George Burns. Okay, you got two now.
Charles.
What do you say, Charles?
My friend, George Kennedy.
George Kennedy. That was lukewarm applause. Nothing personal,
try
Mr. Kennedy.
Try to keep down the rally, if you will.
What about see, George V?
George Kennedy, George Burns, and George Washington. You want one of those? Look at me when I'm talking to you. Thank you, Gary. Face me. Stand right here and face me, man to man, here. Now, you got those three answers, but you don't have to take them if you don't want any one of them.
I'll take Burns.
You're joking!
Uh-oh. The audience is telling you that you blew it.
Is he too young to know who George Washington is?
No, he knows who George is. But the audience can be wrong. We're going to find out right now here. We are looking for George Burns, and we'll find out if George is hiding under the $100 response. Goebel is there.
Larry, has there been any insanity in your family? I was just checking.
Yeah. All right. Now, let's see if George Burns is under the $250 response. Burns it is. Congratulations to you. Better than striking out altogether, isn't it?
Yes.
What do you think's under the other one?
Has to be Washington.
Washington, eh?
George the Fifth.
Not George the Fifth. Slide it, Earl. Six. Washington it is. That's why the audience booed you and awed you when you said Burns instead of Washington. Why did you say that?
That's what I was going to
say. I don't know.
You don't know. It just popped into your head and you thought, well, that's your judgment. It's okay. Now, you got 250 additional. You're up to 350. Now you got a chance to win $2,500 by matching one celebrity exactly. Let's see how you're going to do with this. First, you got to choose one.
Who's George Washington?
Lee.
Lee. You ready?
Oh, no.
Get ready to write.
Confidence.
Yep. Have confidence. Get your ESP going. Lee, transmit some thoughts to him as you write your answer to this.
Yes.
Blank cage. C-A-G-E. Blank cage. Okay, Lee Merriweather is finished. And now, Gary, what answer would you like to give us which you think will match this fugitive from Barnaby Jones?
I said Lion Cage.
Lion Cage.
That goes right along with Washington.
Yeah, that's right. You didn't pick Washington, so naturally you wouldn't... You'd have to say Lion's Cage, wouldn't you? Naturally, it goes along with George Burns there. All right, Lee, he says Lion's Cage will match you for $2,500. What do you say to that?
I don't know. Can I take you to lunch someday and dinner and anything after? Because I went with Bird Cage.
Bird Cage. Your people are telling you. Oh, Richard Ed Lion. Richard the Lionhearted. Yes, hello.
Are you the gentleman that wanted your hairspray from the Brett Graff?
Yeah. A little more back there. Thank you very much. Now, they've turned off the fan, so...
I'm out of business.
That's right, you're out of business.
And I'll probably never act again, either.
That's right, your whole career is destroyed. Now, Gary, you've ended up with a total of $350, and you're going to play another game, so let's welcome your new opponent, shall we? Here comes Betty Johnston. Hello there. Climb aboard when it's done. Hi, Betty.
Hi, how are you, Gene?
You know Gary?
Yes.
Now, Betty, we'd like to find out a little bit about you, if you would, please. Tell us the story of your life.
Okay, I'm married. I don't have any children, but I like to do arts and crafts, and I like children.
Now, you don't get children from arts and crafts.
I know.
I've got to tell you that there.
I did.
I mean, arts and crafts. You know you didn't. Okay, Betty, it's up to you. You stick with your arts and crafts, but if you want to get children, you got to want to go. All right, A or B there?
A, please.
A it is. Here we go. Arts and crafts, eh? Flash Gordon said, "Last week I defeated the meat people, men made entirely out of meat. You'll see how I did it in my next picture. Flash Gordon blanks the meat people."
Oh, honey, now you're going to have to redo that, sweetheart. Just come up here, sweetheart.
Just read it to yourself there.
Oh, all right.
Move your lips silently.
Flash Gordon said, "Last week I defeated the meat people. Men made entirely out of meat. You'll see how I did it in my next picture. Flash Gordon blanks the meat people."
Got the idea now.
No.
Does that help?
Well,
it's a first-round question. You know they're a little tougher than usual. So you had Lion, eh? You had Lion, didn't you? You did have Washington, too, didn't you? He really blew that one, didn't he? All right, let's go. Hurry up, folks. We're running out of time now. Last call, Brett. Here we go to Betty Johnston.
Okay.
Ready? Lee, are you ready? Boy, that long hair has slowed up your brain, Lee.
Yes, I'm sorry.
Now, Betty, Flash Gordon said, "Last week I defeated the meat people, men made entirely out of meat. You'll see how I did it in my next picture, called Flash Gordon Blanks the Meat People."
Butchers?
Flash Gordon butchers the meat people. Little lady over there who believes in arts and crafts says Flash Gordon butchers the meat people. Bill, what do you say?
I was in that movie. It's called Beats.
Beats, right? Beats the meat people.
All right, Brett.
Beats the meat people.
Yep. Maybe see close? At least. No. Butchers, and that's different, entirely different. Brett, would you just hold
one
up your card?
One winner then? Does not a winner make when you've had a series of losing answers. I said, what do we do with a hamburger? We chop or grind.
Chop or grind, Charles?
Well, that's a wonderful answer.
I said he took his gun that shoots a fire and barbecued the meat people.
Barbecues the meat people. Mel Lee, what do you say?
Well, you know how you choose up sides to fight and everything. Well, I said choose.
He chews the meat people. And Richard?
Barbecue.
Barbecues. And Fanny?
Cooks.
He cooks the meat people. So, Betty, your answer didn't do anything for you, and we'll see what yours does for you later, but right now, this. No time to say goodbye. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Coming up on GSN, Jokers Run Wild. Secrets will be told and treasures found.
Join me, Bill Dwyer, as GSN counts down the 50 greatest game shows of all time.
Tonight at 8, 7 Central on GSN. Get in the game.
Thanks. Washington it is. That's why the audience booed you and awed you when you said Burns instead of Washington. Why did you say that?
That's what I was going to
say. I don't know.
You don't know. It just popped into your head and you thought, well, that's your judgment. It's okay. Now, you got 250 additional. You're up to 350. Now you got a chance to win $2,500 by matching one celebrity exactly. Let's see how you're going to do with this. First, you got to choose one.
Who's George Washington?
Lee.
Lee. You ready?
Oh, no.
Get ready to write.
Confidence.
Yep. Have confidence. Get your ESP going. Lee, transmit some thoughts to him as you write your answer to this.
Yes.
Blank cage. C-A-G-E. Blank cage. Okay, Lee Merriweather is finished, and now Gary.